हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू फाइनेंस एमसीक्यू। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द वैकेंसी रिलीज बाय आरसीएफएल। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो। फ्रेंड्स, राष्ट्रीय केमिकल एंड फर्टिलाइजर लिमिटेड हैज रिलीज द रिक्रूटमेंट नोटिफिकेशन फॉर असिस्टेंट ऑफिसर फाइनेंस। हियर इफ यू सी द नेम ऑफ पोस्ट इज असिस्टेंट ऑफिसर फाइनेंस, इट्स अ ईओ ग्रेड वैकेंसी। पे स्केल विल बी इन द रेंज ऑफ 30,000 टू 1,20,000। फ्रेंड, दीज आर परमानेंट वैकेंसीज। देयर आर टोटल 9 वैकेंसीज, आउट ऑफ विच 3 वैकेंसीज आर फॉर अनरिजर्व कैटेगरी कैंडिडेट एंड रेस्ट आर ऑल फॉर रिजर्व कैटेगरी कैंडिडेट। हियर द क्वालिफिकेशन एक्सपीरियंस एंड एज आस्क्ड इज एज ऑन 1 जुलाई 2024। सो बाय दिस डेट यू शुड बी मीटिंग ऑल दिस क्राइटेरिया। द क्वालिफिकेशन ask for this post is regular and full time BCom graduate. Your graduation should be regular, it should not be distance, then only eligible. And apart from that, have passed the CA inter, IPCC or CMA inter, then only eligible. So basically graduation plus CA inter or CMA inter is eligible to apply for this post. Here they have also set the percentage criteria. So you need to score minimum 55% marks in your BCom degree, whereas no percentage criteria for CA inter or CMA inter qualification. So if you are having a 55% and above in your graduation degree and along with CA inter, CMA inter, then you are eligible to apply for this vacancy. Here they have mentioned you also need to have post qualification experience, that is at least 3 years of post qualification experience required after completion your CA inter or CMA inter. Here your articleship experience will not be counted, so do keep this in mind. It has to be post articleship experience, then only it will be counted. And your experience should be in the relevant field of finance, accounts, taxation, cost, accounting, auditing, sales, trade receivables, etc. And here they have specifically mentioned period of experience, article clerk or practical clearing, which are part of your curriculum, shall not be considered as valid experience. And here knowledge of accounting software and SAP is desirable. Candidate having passed final examination from CACMA institute will not be considered. So if you are a qualified CACMA, you will not be considered. You are overqualified for this post. And upper age limit mentioned as on 1st July 2024 is that you should be 30 years for unreserved category candidate, and for SCST 35 years is there, for OBC 33 years, and PWBD category candidate 40 years is there as a age limit. For eligibility criteria with respect to qualification, age and experience is 1st July 2024. So it's a backdated date, so do keep this in mind. Currently September is going on, but in notification they have mentioned you should meet all the criteria as on 1st July 2024. So your 3 years experience should be completed as on 1st July, then only eligible. Application fee, friends, you have to make an application fee of ₹1,000, and SCST, PWBD female candidate are exempt from making application fee. Now nature of job, they have mentioned the company has 2 units in Thal, Alibag and Torambe, Mumbai, and a nationwide marketing office. So selected candidate may be posted at the unit or marketing office of the company as per their requirement. Now salary and other benefits, here they have mentioned that you will be in the EO grade with a pay scale of 30,000 to 1,20,000, with minimum total gross salary works out to be 61,000, which includes your basic, DA, perks, perquisites, etc. Now selection process, very important. So friends, selection process for the assistant officer finance will consist of online test and skill test. There will not be any interview. An online test pattern is also mentioned. Your online test will be of a computer based test, and it will be held in the selected cities, that is Bhopal, Delhi, NCR, Lucknow, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai, Guwahati, Kolkata, Mumbai, Nagpur, and media will be Hindi as well as English. Exam pattern, friends, your online test will have 2 parts. First will be discipline related, that is your technical syllabus, and second part will be aptitude, basically non-technical syllabus, and duration of the test will be 90 minutes and total marks will be 150 marks, out of which 50 questions will be from mix of course curriculum of qualifying degree, which will have 2 marks, and 50 questions from English, quantitative aptitude, reasoning, general knowledge, etc., which will have 1 marks. So basically your technical syllabus will be of 100 marks and non-technical syllabus will be of 50 marks. So you need to prepare more on your domain knowledge, and there will be negative marking for wrong answer. So usually 1/4 will be the negative marking. So we at Finance MCQ will help you to prepare for your technical syllabus, that is of 100 marks, and for non-technical syllabus you can visit PSU exam prep. There you can prepare for reasoning topic. Now skill test. So based on the performance of the candidate in the online test, eligible candidate will be shortlisted and called for skill test in the ratio of 1:7. That is, 7 candidate will be called for one post. And they have also mentioned the description of skill test, what will be there in the skill test. So it will consist of finance operations 40 marks, records handling 10 marks, alertness and responsiveness 10 marks, communication skill 10 marks, safety awareness 10 marks, computer knowledge 20 marks. So like this, total skill test will be of 100 marks. The candidate has to score minimum 60% marks or 60 marks, and for SCST 55 marks out of 100 for qualifying the skill test. And merit list will be prepared for suitable candidate based on the performance in the online test. Your skill test is just a qualifying in nature. So what they will do, first they will conduct the written test and then they will call for the candidate for the skill test in the 1:7. All those candidates who will clear the skill test, then the final merit list will be prepared for those selected candidate who cleared the skill test based on their online exam. So if you have scored very good marks in the online examination, chances are you will be selected provided you clear your skill test. As I already mentioned, online test will have a 100% weightage and skill test will be just a qualifying in nature. Now how to apply? Friends, you have to apply by visiting website of the company through online mode only. Step by step process and detail is mentioned here. You can go through the notification. I will provide the notification link in the description. So you can check the step by step registration process and fill the application form. Now important dates, friends, online application started from 21st September 2024 and last date of making online application is 7th October 2024 till 5 p.m. So by this date you should submit your application form. So that's all, friend. If you are meeting the eligibility criteria and if you are having a desired experience, then you should definitely give it a try. You will get a good opportunity working in a PSU company and it will be beneficial for your future career also. So do give it a try. So thank you so much for watching this video till the end.